Welcome back to the talk. I am here with my friend Jonathan Bagley, who is running for Whitfield County Commission, District 3. Welcome, Jonathan.
Thank you. Thank you for having me.
Well, thank you for coming on. I mean, I'm excited for you. This is kind of like a huge deal. So why did you decide to run for this?
You know, I've had that question a lot, and my thoughts are, why not? You know, there's a lot of guys who have done great things in our county who are kind of getting to the age of slowing down, you know, stepping back, and some of us younger guys, I think, have to step forward and really kind of take the county further. And so I've always had an interest in politics. I definitely love our county and our community, and so I want to try to help be one of those guys.
And you are a lifelong resident of Whitfield County. In fact, you grew up a couple of houses down from where I currently live.
I did, yeah. So I grew up out on the east side of the county, graduated from Southeast High School, currently live in Cajuto. In 2005, my wife and I moved to Cajuto. We bought a small farm, and we live up there and raise some cattle. And she teaches at the Cajuto Creek High School down the street from us. And so grew up on the east side of the county, but 15 or so years ago, we moved up to the north end.
And your wife is?
Stacy Bagley.
Stacy Bagley. Mm-hmm. And you guys have three lovely kids.
We do. We have three children, two daughters, both graduates of Cajuto Creek, and both are currently attending University of Tennessee in Knoxville. And then we have a little boy. He's a fourth grader at Varnell.
Very sweet.
Yeah.
Okay, now a lot of people don't know, I think, what a county commissioner does. So what exactly do you guys do, or will you be doing?
Yeah, great question. So, you know, one of the main functions of the commissioners is to manage the budget for Whitfield County. And they kind of approve and oversee the budgets for, you know, EMS, fire, police, road departments, recreation departments. So, you know, those groups create their budgets, and then the commissioners approve those. And if the budgets are greater than what the taxes are, then, you know, they'll make decisions on should we do a splost or should we raise tax or something like that. So they're really the ones who are kind of managing the money for Whitfield County.
And what qualifies you specifically for this job?
Right, good question. So currently what I do, you know, is my day job is I'm director of procurement for a local chemical company. So I oversee all of our raw material purchasing, and that's kind of, you know, how I get paid week in, week out, and my job is to manage the money wisely for the ownership and the investors of the company that I work for. And so, very similar to what the commissioners do for Whitfield County, the owners and the investors are the citizens of Whitfield County, you and I and everyone else who lives in the county. And so, I would be doing the same role for myself included and everyone else in Whitfield County as I do for the guys I currently are employed by.
And my understanding, the company you work for has a pretty big budget.
It's a sizable budget. It's a good bit bigger than Whitfield County. So I'm kind of used to the county budget for Whitfield is $49 million. And so the one that I currently handle, you know, on a daily basis is a good bit larger than that.
So you are absolutely qualified to do this job.
I think so.
And you care about Whitfield County a lot.
I do.
Through our conversations before, you know, I know this. What challenges would you say Whitfield County faces right now?
Yeah, you know, I think that COVID has exposed a lot of challenges for every county, and ours is no different. And so we got a lot of people who are working from home, maybe students who are taking classes at home. And I know myself, I do a good bit of teleworking from home, and our internet system, especially out in the county, I think in the city of Dalton, they have some very good internet through OptiLink and Dalton Utilities. But the county, we still struggle. And I think that we really need to push to get good high-speed internet all throughout Whitfield County. And you get into the rural areas like where I live and in the north end or the south end, internet becomes a bigger challenge. You get two or three people on at the same time, you may have such slow speeds that you really can't do much. So
it's annoying because, you know, I lived in on the west side for a long time, and most of my life actually. And working from home, you know, writing, trying to get articles in or whatever, sometimes it was almost impossible. Not to mention when the kids were doing homework or whatever. So we faced a lot of challenges with that internet.
Yeah.
Those of us who are in the city now, I think don't really, well, I do, but a lot of people who've never dealt with that don't realize It's not quite as bad as the dial-up days because, yeah. you know, we probably, I don't know about you, but I remember the dial-up days.
Oh, for sure.
And yeah. it was rough.
Yeah.
That is important.
Yeah. Yeah, I think it's a real challenge as more and more, you know, I think Dalton was just voted one of the top 10 places to work from home in the state of Georgia or something like that. And so, mm-hmm. in Whitfield County. So,
wow.
It's a great, it, you know, as more and more people start working from home for whatever reasons, I think we got to have the infrastructure mm-hmm. there to help support that. So I think that, you know, maybe the county commissioners could do some jointly stuff with Dalton Utilities to help facilitate that a little bit better.
Sounds good. I know you've got a lot of good ideas because we had a conversation the other night, you, myself, mm-hmm. and my fiance about mm-hmm. your ideas and the things that you have in plan. You have planned. We just don't even have time to get into it all. But I know that you have thoughts on the taxes.
Right. Yeah, you know, I think that, you know, that's one of the number one things that everybody wants to talk about when someone's running for office, and no one wants to see their taxes go up, and myself included. And so, you know, we got to make sure that, you know, whoever we hire to do this job, because we're all the owners of Whitfield County, and we're the guys that's going to be employing this guy to or lady to do the job, that, you know, they're qualified, that they're going to be good stewards of our taxes and our money. They're going to spend it wisely, and they're going to not go out and raise our taxes. So part of my goal is to make sure that we don't raise taxes, that we do good financial stewardship, and I think that all the citizens of Whitfield County would kind of appreciate that.
Oh, absolutely. And what about jobs?
Jobs for sure. I think that, you know, there's so many things out there that like you see these Amazons coming into Chattanooga, the Volkswagens coming into Chattanooga. Why can we not get some of those guys to look at Whitfield County? We got
Yes. Got
that huge industrial park down in Carbondale, great mm-hmm. facility right off I-75. We got to go attract some of those guys to bring some of that to our county.
Absolutely. Mm-hmm. And finally, your part of your platform is you want Whitfield County to be a good place to raise the family.
Yeah, absolutely. You know, I've raised my three children here.
And my three I raised here.
Yeah, your three. And so it's a great place to live and grow. You know, I was born and raised here, and I had opportunities to move to other places, but I just love Whitfield County mm-hmm. and Dalton. And
sure.
We have a lot to offer, and we can do more. There's more things we can offer. And so we want to make sure that we have good roads, you know, clean city streets and good schools and good recreation departments for the kids to play. And so I hope to help make all those things a little bit better.
I love to hear that. So Jonathan, how can these folks vote for you?
Okay, so early voting starts February 22nd, and you can go early vote at the courthouse, or, you know, if you want to do the mail-in ballot, you just have to call over there and they can send you a ballot out to mail in. Election day is March 16th, and I would really appreciate it if you guys would consider voting for me and give me a shot. I think I'll do you a good job.
Absolutely. Jonathan Bagley, thank you for coming out.
Thank you for having me, Connie.
And the rest of you, I'll be right back.
The city of Dalton in Whitfield County is a great place to live, work, and grow. I'm Jonathan Bagley, and I'm running for county commissioner for Whitfield County's District 3. My wife, Stacy, and I were born and raised in Whitfield County. We live on a small family farm with our three children, Jenna, Shay, and Caleb. I promise to fight to help keep taxes low, jobs high, and create a great community to raise our families. I'd be honored if you would consider voting for me on March 16th. I'm Jonathan Bagley. Thank you for your support.
Shout out to today's guest, Jonathan Bagley, and to singer-songwriter Ben Honeycutt for sharing his music, and to all of you for watching. As promised, we have another song performed by Ben. Here's his rendition of the classic Stand By Me. Enjoy. See you next time.
Has come and the land is dark I will see. No, I won't be afraid. No, I won't be afraid. Just as long as you stand by me. So darling, darling, stand by me. Oh, stand by me. Oh, stand now, stand by me. Stand by me. When the sky that we look upon should tumble and fall, and the mountains should crumble to the sea, I won't cry, I won't cry. No, I won't shed a tear. Just as long as you stand by me. So darling, darling, stand by me. Oh, stand by me. Oh, stand now, stand by me. Stand by me. Whenever you're in trouble, won't you stand by me? Oh, stand by me. Stand by me. Stand by me. Stand by me.
Division in my mind. It's time for me to go.